你等啊，你等。看我一箱啥？
多啦，大家，唔該曬。好就做。係啊，歡迎大家今日出席選管會就2019年區議會一般選舉選區分界及名稱臨時建議公眾諮詢嘅記者會。咁我先介紹咧，台上面咧就有選管會主席馮華法官啦。選管會兩位委員陸怡信資深大律師同埋張妙清教授嘅，咁另外仲有就係選舉事務處總選舉事務主任黃思文先生同埋副總選舉事務主任陳竹燕女士嘅。咁記者會咧就會分兩個環節，咁首先咧就會請主席簡介建議嘅內容啦，之後就會係提問嘅時間嘅。咁唔該主席，
歡迎各位出席今日嘅記者會。2019年區議會一般選舉咧，係會喺出年嘅年底舉行嘅。咁根據法例咧，選管會係需要為呢個選舉嘅選區分界同埋選區名稱咧制定臨時建議，並且咧就進行公眾諮詢，然後喺今年11月咧向行政長官咧提交個正式建議嘅。咁根據區議會條例規定咧。現時香港咧係分咗做18個地方行政區，咁每個地方行政區咧係會設立一個區議會，咁而每個地方行政區咧亦都係會劃分咗有多個議席，每個劃分咗多個選區，而每個選區咧係有一個民選議席，咁現時香港咧一共有431個選區同埋民選議席嘅。咁喺2014年選區劃界嗰陣時咧，當時嘅2015年年中，即係嗰個區議會選舉年嘅年中嘅人口推算咧，係有731,1300人。而今次咧，我哋推算咧，用區議院選舉年咧，即係2019年嘅年中咧嘅人口係752,600人。就2020年1月起運作嘅新一屆區議會咧，政府係根據區議會條例咧，喺舊年咧就按時照當時嘅推算咧嘅2019年年中各行政區嘅預計人口數字咧，檢討咗民選議席嘅數目。咁並且喺今年年初咧，立法會係通過咗附屬法例咧，就喺10個行政區咧，一共增加咗21個民選議席。因此，新一屆嘅區議會嘅民選議席嘅總數咧，係會由而家嘅431席咧，增加到452席啦。咁選管會咧，亦都係根據法例咧，係有需要咧喺有關嘅行政區咧劃多21個新增選區。咁即是喺2019年嘅區議會一般選舉咧，全港咧係劃分為452個選區嘅。咁就選區分界嘅檢討咧， 我哋係按照法例嘅規定咧，係喺今年初咧，取得各選區喺2019年年中最新嘅預計人口數字。咁我哋都係根據翻選舉管理委員會條例列出嘅法定準則，同埋選管會一貫嘅工作原則咧，制定咗臨時建議，由今日起咧開始諮詢公眾，就為期30日，直至到8月21日為止。嗰啲法定準則同埋工作原則咧，係已經載列咗喺大家已經得到嗰個諮詢文件裏頭，主席的話嗰個附錄一嗰度啦。首先我講下呢啲劃界嘅法定要求。法例規定咧，我哋必須根據來屆區議會嘅一般選舉年，即係2019年嘅預計人口咧，檢視所有選區嘅現有分界，同埋適當咁調整預計人口會超出法例許可上限或者下限嘅選區，令佢哋嘅預計人口咧符合翻法例許可嘅幅度。至於預計人口喺許可幅度之內嘅選區咧，原則上咧，我哋係唔需要主動調整佢嘅分界嘅。有個數咧係叫做標準人口基數，呢個咧係以2019年年中全港預計人口752,600人咧，除以全香港區議會民選議席嘅總數452。得出嚟一個人口數字16,599人，而法例許可幅度咧，就係喺每個選區嘅人口咧，係唔可以超出標準人口基數25%嘅上下限。所以咧，每個選區嘅人口咧，係必須要介乎12,449人至到27,409人之間，否則是超出許可幅度。咁呢個計算法呢，亦都可以睇翻喺主席的話嗰個附錄一裏邊。咁法例規定喺調整選區分界嗰陣時咧，我哋除咗考慮預計人口之外咧，亦必須係顧及社區獨特性、地方聯繫嘅維持，同埋有關區域嘅自然特徵。例如地理啊，同埋交通方便程度等其他嘅法定因素嘅，所以咧，我哋唔可以淨係硬性咁從法例嗰個許可幅度嗰度嘅要求咧，就係劃界，亦都要顧及其他嘅法定因素。正因為係咁咧，喺合理嘅情況之下咧。為了顧及所有的法定因素，我們會建議容許有關的選區的人口偏離許可幅度是超過那個法例的限制，但是主要我們都是出發點都是保持人口在法定許可幅度之內的。那針對預計人口會偏離許可幅度的選區調整分界嗰陣時咧，係必然會對佢哋毗鄰嘅選區咧有所影響嘅。咁因此有啲嘅選區，即使佢哋個人口咧係符合一個許可幅度，係因為佢哋係要相應配合嗰啲需要劃界嘅選區咧，佢哋自己嗰個區界咧都不免係需要調整啦。不過為了減少調整分界可能對選民造成的不便呢，我們調整選區分界的時候呢，是會以影響最少選區數目或者較少的人口為基本原則的。那我也都想趁這個機會講一講呢，就是調整選區分界呢是可以有很多不同的方法的，就並冇話唯一或者絕對嘅方案嘅。我哋係考慮到各方面嘅因素，主要考慮人口數字啦，咁亦都考慮頭先講過嘅其他法定因素啦。 但是我们就绝对不会考虑政治或者同法例要求无关的理由的。那我们也都是会用同一套的法定基准呢，是比较不同的方案，那选出来认为最可取的作这个临时建议。同样地呢，我们也都是用回这一套基准呢去考虑今次公众咨询期内收到的申述和建议的。现在讲一讲那个划界的临时建议的概要。总括来讲呢，今届呢是有84个选区的预计人口呢是会超出或者低于法例许可的上下限的。而今次要划定的新增选区呢就有21个，咁就比上屆嗰個19個係多咗兩個嘅。今次調整現有選區分界數目係有128個，比起2015年咧嘅109個啊多咗19個。雖然今次新增選區咧只係多咗兩個，但係今屆咧係有較多嘅選區嘅預計人口咧係大幅超出許可幅度。超出標準人口基數100%的選區呢，今次有6個，例如觀塘區的寶達選區呢是超出329%的。那2015年呢就只是得一個選區的超出百分比是超過100的。所以今次要相應地調整鄰近選區分界的數目呢亦都是多了。另外呢，今次我們建議容許偏離許可幅度的選區呢是只有12個，比起2015年所容許的24個呢是少了的。正如我們在上一屆的劃界報告書那裡講了呢，就即使某一個選區在上次劃界是獲准偏離許可幅度呢，是不意味著在下一次劃界呢是必然會容許偏離的。選管會呢每次都是重新研究過每一個個案，看看有沒有辦法呢可以將人口呢調整回到去許可幅度之內。今次容許偏離許可幅度的12個選區之中呢，有7個是調整了分界之後呢它是仍然超出幅度的。我舉一個例呢，就好像離島區一樣的。咁因為咧，佢今次嘅新建成房屋入伙咧，係有好大幅度嘅上升。但係基於離島區嘅地理咧，選區之間係所隔好遠，而交通亦都唔方便嘅，所以用嚟調撥人口嘅毗鄰選區嘅選擇咧，係有好大限制。因此咧，唔係所有選區都可以調整到去許可幅度之內，雖然是這樣呢，其實是已經大幅收窄了他們超出法例許可上限的幅度。至於新選區的建議名稱和分區分選區要調整了之後要改名呢，我們主要是考慮回那個建議的區界裡頭的地標、道路或者屋苑的名稱。咁我哋都有徵詢民政事務專員嘅意見嘅。咁為咗方便公眾知道有關嘅分界改動咧，所有需要作出改動嘅選區嘅資料同埋人口獲容許偏離可幅度嘅選區，同埋選管會嘅考慮原因咧，我哋都載咗喺主席的話嘅附錄二嗰度噶，你哋可以詳細睇一睇。另外講一啲地圖咧，咁18個地方行政區嘅地圖同埋其他嘅圖咧，藍線咧就係代表2015年區議會選區嘅原區界，紅線咧就係選管會今次建議嘅新區界，至於紅邊藍心嘅線咧就代表選區區界維持不變，大家亦都可以睇下嗰啲地圖。佢亦都係有其他嗰啲改動嘅原因資料咧，你哋都可以去了解一下。咁根據選管條例咧， 臨時建議咧，同埋啲地圖咧，係由今日起就作出公眾查閱，諮詢期咧係30日。市民咧可以登入選管會嘅網站 www.eac.gov.hk， 或者到各區嘅民政諮詢中心、選舉事務處、郵政局、公共屋邨辦事處、主要同埋分區公共圖書館參閱嗰啲分界建議圖同埋說明。我哋歡迎任何人士向選管會提交書面意見，或者出席我哋所舉辦嘅兩場公眾諮詢大會嘅任何一場，發表佢哋對呢啲分界嘅意見。個公眾諮詢大會咧係會喺8月1日同埋8月3日舉行嘅，就分別喺荔枝角社區會堂同埋沙田龍坑社區中心。個時間咧就係晚上7時去到9時30。咁兩次公眾諮詢大會咧，都係可以聽取任何一個選區嘅意見嘅。選管今日所發表嘅咧係臨時建議，而家就做公眾諮詢，希望公眾能夠積極發表意見。無論係支持或者反對嘅意見咧，我哋歡迎嘅，就請你提翻嗰個理據俾我哋考慮。咁所有嘅書面意見一定要在8月21日或者之前交到嚟俾選管會，之後的意見咧就對唔住我哋唔會考慮噶啦。多謝各位。The Electoral Affairs Commission is releasing for public consultation its provisional recommendations on the boundaries and names of the 452 proposed constituencies in the 18 administrative districts.For the 2019 District Council ordinary election. The consultation shall run from today until August 21st. Members of the public are invited to express their views on the proposals. The Commission has followed the statutory criteria under the electoral law and is established working principles in delineating the proposed constituencies.As set out in the consultation document. The Commission is required to examine the existing boundaries of all constituencies on the basis of the projected population in the District Council ordinary election year, that is 2019. The projected population of Hong Kong in mid-2019 is 7,502,600. According to the law, the population in a constituency should not exceed or fall below the population quota by more than 25%. The population quota is obtained by dividing the projected population by the total number of 452 elector seats, and the population quota for each constituency is 16,500.And 99. Factoring in the upper and lower limits of 25% of the population quota, the statutory permissible range of the population in each constituency is between 12,449 and 20,749.The Commission shall adjust the boundaries of those constituencies with projected population exceeding the statutory permissible range of population. For constituencies where the projected population do fall within the permissible range, in principle, the boundaries remain the same unless corresponding adjustments are required due to the changes in the adjacent affected constituencies.Apart from taking into account the projected population, the Commission must also have regard to the other statutory factors, including community identities, preservation of local ties, and physical features, such as the size, shape, accessibility, and development of the relevant areas when adjusting the constituency boundaries. The EAC has adopted the established working principle of affecting the least number of existing constituencies or the less population, so as to minimize any possible inconvenience to electors. In summary, the Commission has delineated 21 new constituencies in accordance with the order passed by the Legislative Council earlier this year for the creation of 21 new elected seats for the next term of district councils. The Commission has proposed to adjust the boundaries of 128 existing constituencies. By way of comparison, 109 constituencies had their boundaries adjusted in the last delineation exercise. In addition, the Commission has proposed to allow 12 constituencies to depart from the permissible range of population, having regard to the statutory factors of community identities, preservation of local ties, and the physical features of the areas concerned. By way of comparison, 24 constituencies were allowed to depart from the permissible range in 2015. It must be emphasized that the Commission does not take into account any political factors or factors not relevant to the statutory requirements as set out in the electoral law. During the consultation period, written representations may be sent to the Commission. Late submissions after August 21st will not be entertained. Members of the public may also express their views orally at any one of the two public forums on the August 1st at the Lai Chi Kok Community Hall and on August 3rd at the Sha Tin Lung Hang Estate Community Centre. The forums shall start from 7 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. and views on any of the constituencies may be expressed on either of the 2 days. The Commission will submit its report on the final recommendations to the Chief Executive after taking into account representations received during the consultation period. Thank you.
現在提問時間，麻煩先講你嘅機構係屬於即係咩機構嘅名稱？白色三個位男士，你好，
馮官，有線電視。想問三個問題㗎，第一個問題咧，主要係想問翻即係關於嗰個人口比例個上限多咗，然後劃分一個新區出嚟。個例子就好似觀塘區個 J10 安里個區啦，同埋元朗 M22嘉湖南呢兩個區嘅，咁就將原本咧一個屋村又或者屋苑咧幾棟大廈咧就分為兩個區，咁就想逢觀下即係其實會唔會影響咗嗰個選區，即係嗰個屋苑或者屋村裏面咧嗰個完整性，嗰個屋苑啲居民咧，即係會唔會好難適從，究竟自己屬於邊一個選區咧？同埋另一方面，即係好似觀塘 J10。安理個選區咁樣啦，就好似其實一個選區係服務緊三條村嘅，會唔會令到即係當區個區議員咧係其實會更加難去服務當區嘅居民？呢個第一個問題。第二個問題就係相反啦，就係有一啲區咧係超出咗個人口上限，亦都係即係容許啊，就好似離島區、日東村南同埋北就 T02 同埋 T03。佢哋都各自超出咗40%啊！佢其實個數字加埋咧，呢兩個區咧係夠開三，即係開多一區啊，變成三個區嘅。咁但係個原因咧就話，因為考慮到離島個地理啊、交通啊、人口分布嗰啲限制，咁所以就繼續係用兩個區。想問一下係即係基於啲乜嘢理由去唔開多一個區咧？即係其實因為個數字係足夠開三個區噶嘛。咁另外最後一個問題就想問埋咧，阿馮官關於嚟緊區議會選舉咧，會唔會同立法會選舉睇齊？即係關於啲民主自決啊、港獨呢啲咧，會唔會俾選舉主任根據啲條例去撤銷個參選資格咧？唔該，馮官。
嗯。我想趁起啲由頭講，我頭先讀曬出嚟嘅啦。你可以知道咧，我哋可以考慮嘅理由咧。就喺嗰個法例寫曬出嚟嘅，咁我喺附錄一咧都俾咗你哋。最大個理由咧係嗰度寫住 A 個理由咧係個人口，咁個人口嗰個基數咧，我哋頭先講過出嚟咧就係、是、16599。咁法例咧就話你最好咧就貼近呢個人口基數啦。 如果唔係咧，你可以超過佢上25%，下25%，就係12449同埋20749。呢個佢寫在 A 嗰度咧，同埋 B 嗰度咧，就最好人口基數。如果唔係就25%嘅上下限。香港嗰個人口基數咧，如果你係話要每一個佢都符合咧，係基本上冇可能，除非你係將同一棟大廈唔同嘅樓層去劃分，因為我哋香港咧都係多層大廈，人口好密集嘅。咁樣嚟講咧，我哋係唔想話同一間大廈劃分呢個，我諗大家都可以理解嘅。咁我哋所以咧變成係切實可行咧，我哋只可以咧就係、是、保持佢喺嗰個法庭許可幅度嗰度，即係嗰個12499去到20749。咁呢個就係嗰度 B 寫咗噶啦。佢話你一定跟 A， 跟唔到咧你就跟 B 啦。B 嗰度咧你要考慮咧。就係嗰啲社區聯繫啊、地方嗰啲啊特色啊咁樣，喺好強烈嘅理由咧，咁你連 A 同 B 加埋即係 B， 你都唔跟啦。如果唔係咧，盡量你都係要跟 B 嘅。咁你可以睇我成個選區嗰個分界嗰個原則咧，就係想有相約嘅人數咧，係選出一位佢哋嘅代表。呢個是最大的原則，这个就是一個用數字上最客觀去劃分，還有其他呢你就要遵從。所以我都知道大家都會、很有興趣什麼叫社區聯繫。你想想香港現在新開一條新屋邨2萬多至4萬人，根本在這樣的前提之下呢，它是一定超過了我哋一個選區嘅人口上限。咁亦都喺以往嘅劃界裏頭咧，一條屋邨嘅唔同座數咧，分為唔同嘅選區咧，係比比皆是嘅。因為呢個係一個切實可能嘅做法，因為我哋個選區係幾大，有幾多個議席咧，呢、這個係已經係附屬法例定咗出嚟嘅。咁呢個選管會咧，就不是話點解我哋唔開多一席，因為呢個唔係我哋有權去開多一席，我哋有咁多席咧就去開。咁有個離島嘅例子，啱啱我可以再詳細講。所以如果你話要裝整條屋村，譬如你係有啲觀塘區嗰啲屋村咧，去到成40000人，其實咧係冇可能佢係得一個屋村。咁所以咧，我哋就考慮到咧數字嘅問題。咁你話地區嗰個服務咧，咁其實呢個唔係嗰個法律上邊嘅理由嚟嘅。咁當然我哋嘅工作守則亦都唔考慮地方嘅行政啦，亦都唔考慮嗰個政治因素啦。咁但係以我哋嘅角度嚟睇，係從一個區議會去服務整個行政區咧，呢、這個我哋亦都睇唔出有啲問題。咁至於你話有一間屋邨，佢尤其是新入去嘅話，佢嗰個地方聯繫我哋睇咧，咁我哋喺2015年嗰個區議會報告亦都寫話咧，睇嗰個地方聯繫咧，佢有唔同嘅角度。如果係人民嘅因素咧，我哋好多時係睇嗰啲傳統上邊嘅地方聯繫，即係例如喺鄉郊地區咧，係有啲好強烈嘅傳統嘅地方聯繫。譬如有氏族啊，或者佢哋係有各個唔同嘅佢哋嘅鄉郊嘅組織啊，咁我哋會考慮嘅。譬如一個墟鎮咁樣，咁佢係屬於一個墟嘅話，咁我哋梗係話佢多咗幾個人，我哋都有佢成為一個墟。咁如果一個墟斬開咗就唔同，但係你話嗰啲城市化嗰啲之後咧，嗰啲地區聯繫咧，嗰度其實咧就變成。客觀上不是那麼強，反而呢在城市裏頭呢，我們很多時呢都是看地理和交通，看他們大致生活上面呢，他們會不會真的地理分隔了。離島選區那裡呢是有一個獨特的問題，離島選區那裡呢是有一個很幅員很廣，是很分散的人口， 因為佢有唔同嘅組聚，所以有時咧就係計嗰條數出嚟，係話佢有咁多嘅整個離島嘅區議會有咁多席咧，係唔係代表喺大嶼山咧，我哋可以用得上咁多席嘅？咁大家亦都睇到咧，我哋今次咧係有個動作咧，就係長洲本來佢有兩席嘅。因為長洲都是一個島，佢一個雅寧嘅，佢分開了，但我哋認為呢個社區聯繫同埋交通咧，一個島嗰啲頭都係長洲啫。咁我哋其實咧就係佢超上限咧，我哋都係將佢結合咗嚟到空咗一席出嚟咧，係俾我哋咧可以喺其他大嶼山嗰度用噶啦。但其他有啲其他有四個離島，佢離天隔上遠，亦都冇交通嘅。咁如果你話我哋跟翻法例話佢嗰個交通方便程度同埋個聯繫咧，咁佢分得最遠嘅我哋都唔跟，咁呢個我哋講唔過嘅。所以咧，我哋知道咧係喺東涌嗰度劃咗啲新選區咧，其實佢係已經係即係劃完之後佢都有超上啊，但其實我哋係已經從佢原本係。100%以上咧，係都回落到大概40%嗰度。咁呢個咧就係要睇下將來有冇機會咧，佢仲增加議席嗰度有。因為我哋喺啲離島嗰度嚟到再好似我哋長洲嗰度咧，我哋空間真係好有限噶啦。咁至於你話參選提名嗰啲咧，咁我都次次都講翻咧，呢個係一個選舉主任佢按照個。法律的規定咧，去負責嘅，咁選管會咧係冇評論嘅。
I'm Maggie Hill from RTHK. Mr. Justice Fong, my question is also about the criticisms that some new boundaries don't make sense. For example, in Kingswood, in Tin Shui Wai, some say the area of the new constituencies are too large, and in Kwun Tong, the new boundaries will have broken up local communities. What I want to know is, do you think these complaints are legitimate, and do you think there is a need to review the mechanism to divide divide up the areas so that while population is your major concern, maybe you can give more weight to the other factors that you've just mentioned to avoid, you know, the situation, the such criticisms or such complaints.
Yes, we must work from the statutory criteria in order to understand how the EAC came up with its recommendations.I have just explained that the primary consideration is the population. This is to achieve equal representation. That is more or less the same number of people will have one representative serving them. And the law has stated that it's a population quota. Of course, it's almost impossible to say that in each constituency, you have the population reached. Because otherwise, you have to cut up different floors in a building, you know, given that Hong Kong is a high-rise city. So we, in a way that following the statutory criteria, will achieve that the population do fall within the permissible range with its plus and minus 25% from the population quota. This we strive very hard to do so, because the law, as it is so provided, laid emphasis on the population, and we could only deviate from the population if there were cogent factors on local ties and shapes and geography, etc. As to the criteria, they are the law in the legislation, and the EAC is to operate within those sets of criteria, and it's not the province of the EAC to change them. Also, we have given the additional number of newly created seats, they are given. We cannot seek to add more seats because they are provided by subsidiary legislation passed by LegCo earlier this year. And as to the local communities, and as in the 215 report, I have stated that in considering communities or community ties, mostly traditionally we looked to the traditional ties in now more remote rural areas. With urbanizations and the development of transport, local communities are more diluted. And just one question in Chinese asked, why did you seek to carve up a housing estate? For example, there was a new housing estate in Kuntong. You can look at the figures in the documents. A new housing estate has population of between 20 to 40,000 people. We have the population quota of 16,599, and hence plus or minus 25%, 12,449 and 20,749. You can start to see that it's impossible that we maintain one housing estate within one constituency. And if you look at past papers, it is so common that one housing estate is carved up into two or more constituencies. And the factor we look more nowadays are the features such as the geographical locations and the transport factors and the shape, so that in carving up the estate we will follow more natural lines, such as one is on the top of the slope and the other is below and things like that. Because, I mean, given the number of population in each constituency, and given the fact that we have high-rise population, then and it is impossible that we will keep everyone together. But we and also fail to see why those people cannot be properly served by the district council as a whole. And may I add that we do not consider any political factors or factors pertaining to local administration.
Hey, 你好，獨立媒體in media嘅記者啦。咁頭先馮官講到啦，今次嘅選區分界咧係並冇有涉及一啲政治嘅考慮啦，但我哋留意到咧，一啲民主上要議員嘅一啲選區咧係被重劃嘅，其中就包括元朗區嘅擴進宇嘅北朗區啦，同埋西貢范國威嘅雲亨啦。咁會唔會俾人有一種感覺，就係今次會涉及一個政治考慮咧？另外亦都想問下啦，由尖旺區二十七嗰度啦，尖東同埋京士柏咧，今年咧亦都會重新係劃過嘅。咁我哋留意到咧，其實喺上屆咧亦都有重新，因為sorry，喺上屆咧有重新劃過，而今屆咧就因為人口嘅下限啦，亦都重新劃過嘅。咁我想問會唔會有一個好混亂嘅感，俾公眾有一種好混亂嘅感覺咧？唔該。
首先咧，嗰個人口咧係成件事嗰個嘅原因嚟嘅，要劃過。因為咧，嗱你都知道咧，四年前同而家咧多咗差唔多20萬人口。第二咧，今次嘅新落成公屋咧，比上次真係大幅高咗嘅。我只係講事實，我唔去講佢背後點解。 咁你知道公屋嗰個特色咧，就係佢一般搬幾萬人入去嘅，咁佢唔係話一啲單棟式嘅，咁所以咧係有咁大嘅轉變咧，就要重劃。咁重劃咧，佢成個法例設計咧，佢都係睇下有咁多嘅居民，雖然佢係用居民做基礎，佢就唔係選民，但係即係居民就有咁樣選出嚟一個代表。 所以喺咁嘅情況嘅前設之下咧，佢係一定要重劃，又一定對現時嘅咧係有影響嘅。 因為係嗰個世界變咗，嗰個人口分布。咁嗰個問題咧就係、是，你如果你要重劃嘅話，你有邊啲客觀基準咧係會可以啊最係公道咁去做咧？因為如果我哋你話重劃嘅咧，我哋全部唔知邊個人係邊個區，我哋冇考慮嘅。咁我諗你如果要攞啲例子，就話邊個議員邊個咩嗰啲區，好多例子我諗係有重劃過嘅，因為你有成百幾個區重劃，咁你有百幾個議員一定受影響㗎。咁我都唔知佢哋係咩嘢嘅背景，但係咧，我哋反而咧個法例就叫我哋你客觀嘅，所以咧嗱，第一我哋今日係建議嘅，建議我哋真係去聽意見嘅。咁如果佢出嚟咧，我哋用同一法尺。如果佢係影響嗰個選區少咗，或者影響選區係同數嘅，但係個人口少咗咧，我哋就用依啲嘅。呢、這個就係因為我哋用咗呢個咧，所以可能先影響到咁多人，就因為呢個係客觀公道係最講得通嘅。咁你話你聽嗰、那個意見之後會唔會重劃㗎？你睇翻上次啊，有啊。例如沙田咁大個區，我哋都係，因為佢有啲數係重劃。嗱，我講過頭先係用一個比較方式，就我哋係最明顯就係邊度最多新屋起，我哋就去畫個出嚟啦。但有陣時都要揾多幾個嚟到比較，就係話啊，原來有啲佢喐少啲都可以救到嘅咧，咁我哋咪攤曬出嚟，就咁樣嚟到去畫咯。咁所以係。有意見咧，我哋就係又由頭計一次數，咁樣嚟到睇下邊個好啲唔好啲。咁即係嗱，你睇下呢啲因為以個法例只係話我哋要劃幅地圖出嚟嘅啫。咁我自從上一期起咧，我已經係喺呢個階段盡量俾説明，而喺最終報告咧係每一條都答翻，每一條數攞翻出嚟嘅。所以你哋要睇翻上一次嗰度咧，你可能係知道。哦，原來就係真係計數嘅，咁樣咧就係話，如果佢真係有影響咧，呢個係無可避免嘅。不過我哋就係用一個就係話，嗰條數係最符合我哋嘅法定嘅準則嘅咧，我哋攞嗰條數。
紅色衫嗰位。
你好，馮官，信報嘅周依羅，有兩個問題嘅。第一個係關於嗰個嘅人口基數，因為見到近年嗰、那個選管會嘅趨勢咧，係如果超出咗個上限就會加位啦，但如果超出個下限咧，通常就唔會話冒然去減位嘅，咁就變咗好似港島個別嘅區域咧，就好似就算唔減都係維持住十零席，但係個別新界區因為嗰個人口遷移嘅問題，就變咗好似係不斷咁樣膨脹。咁就想問即係而家咁樣嘅持續用1.6万多啲嘅人口基數係咪一個理想嘅數目啦？會唔會擔心如果再係咁樣持續落去嘅話，嗰、那個區議會嗰個數目會變得更加龐大咧？即係可能下一屆 keep 住會繼續加。第二個問題就係有啱啱3/11補選都有啲最後冇參選嘅議員。咧佢哋就都反映咧，就係話可能傳媒去報導個別嘅人可能考慮參選，但係已經被視為一個參選人或者候選人，即係佢哋會覺得係受到困擾嘅，即係可能已經要求佢哋申報開支，都想知道究竟嗰個準則喺邊度咧？即係傳媒要點樣報導先至為之一個真正嘅候選人咧？唔該啊，同埋另外頭先嗰個確認書一個問題，即係我哋大家都有興趣，唔該。
嗰、那個人口基數咧，1.6万呢個咧，就係有咁多席去除出嚟嘅。咁呢個咧就係加減25% 之後咧，就係選管會嗰個工作範圍啦。但係佢有幾多席咧？佢點樣定出嚟咧？呢、這個就唔係選管會嘅範疇嚟嘅。佢係已經俾咗呢條數，法律叫我哋你跟啦。咁你啲問題我都有思考過嘅，但係唔到我哋話時間呢、這個，我哋就係話盡量佢俾咗我哋咁咧，我哋就跟翻法定嗰啲理由俾到最好啦。傳媒 報道咧，我咧就係準備咗有啲嘢想講下嘅。咁但係咧，今日咧就主題咧就係、是、講呢、這個畫界咧，所以連同話你話確認書嗰啲嘢咧，我一陣間係完咗呢個答問環節咧，我會同大家講幾句嘅。
喂，馮官你好，東方日報 Ivy 啊，我想問翻咧，其實就係、是、就住咧安達臣發展區嗰度嘅，其實而家咧安達臣發展區兩條村咧人口咧就咁加落去都應該係可以分到三個區，我知道咧。上邊咧，即有區議員有建議過咧，喺安達臣發展區嗰度咧，就分翻安泰、安達，跟住安泰同安達咧，而家撥落去秀茂坪中同埋安利嗰度咧，嗰六座咧夾埋咗一個區嘅。咁點解呢個建議唔去考慮，而去保留佢嘅完整性咧？另外就安利選區嗰邊，其實議員咧去走三條村，佢哋非常之辛苦咧，都亦都有見過，不如將安利選區拆開佢啦。咁就因為佢人口比較少，而好似就係選佢哋覺得選管會為咗增加人口去符合法例，然之後夾硬撥。咗三座樓俾佢哋，咁佢哋覺得令到佢哋嗰個服務唔夠完整，同埋從地理上邊佢哋隔緊四條行車線嘅地區咧，佢哋比較偏遠咧，區議員冇辦法去做一個服務，咁啊想問翻點解唔去考慮啦？咁另外咧，就係、是、亦都想問翻咧，即係而家嗰個人口基數保持住都係追翻頭先1.6万嗰個位啦，其實會唔會考慮翻咧增加翻個人口，然之後令到咧所有地區咧個完整性會更加好？唔該。
首先講咗個1.6万咧，我頭先講咧，呢個1.6万係除出嚟嘅，咁佢係決定於咧，佢總共咧係俾全香港區議會喺每一個區議會咧，你有幾多席嘅？咁呢個係對於選區管理委員會係前設嘅，我哋就冇得去改嗰條數嘅，所以咧呢、這個咧就要留翻有翻當局咧。佢要考慮或者佢整體去檢討嗰陣時咧，佢去考慮，所以我哋就冇得唔跟嘅。咁至於你話有啲新選區佢有好多屋村落成咧，我哋咧嗰個工作咧就係唔係得一個，我哋係計出嚟咧係睇下我哋明明邊個咧，因為你譬如你呢三個好好嘅。你搞到其他啲全部爆曬咧，我哋又做唔到嘅。即係我哋係，我喺上次個選舉會報導咧，我哋係以一個宏觀，我哋唔可以個狹隘嗰、那個，即係話我呢三個區就靚到不得了啦，冚唪唥其他咧都唔合格嘅，咁我哋又唔得嘅，我哋有成盤嘅。不過嗱，我唔去話呢個我哋係咪最好，因為我哋而家就係公眾諮詢，如果佢係有。好的建議，我哋就會去再計過條數。咁當然啦，我哋係要總共，你頭先我講，我唔係淨係睇嗰三個選區噶嘛，係總共成個區我影響幾多個？你話就曬佢嘅，人人都咁，我哋唔係用呢個角度，因為大家睇個角度唔同咧，係出發點唔同嘅。咁我哋係盡量客觀，同埋係睇曬成盤嘅。咁樣咧，至於服務嗰度咧，我頭先講過咧，就話呢個咧就唔係一個法定嗰、那個考慮嘅，因為我哋亦都係成日提醒我哋自己咧，我哋係唔考慮地方政治嘅，我哋就係用翻啲數目字啊，同埋嗰啲邊度你話係交通啊，如果佢話隔咗四條路嘅話，可能有啲係隔六條路都唔頂嘅啦。咁所以我哋係用比較方式嘅，所以我頭先講冇絕對冇最好，就係攞翻出嚟，我哋每一個比較過詳盡嘅解釋，你睇翻我哋上一次開始全部落曬喺度㗎啦，咁好清楚嘅。
係 standard 嘅。頭先留意到馮官話唔會考慮地方政治，但係睇翻有啲區頭先都提過，例如話元朗、北朗咁樣見到嗰個考慮因素話，即係佢唔係超越個人口啊，係只係預計人口非常接近上限，已經將北朗選區一分為二咗 變咗做北朗同埋元朗東頭。而家元朗東頭咧，基本上是一個真空嘅區域嚟嘅。咁原本當區嘅區議員可能喺成個大區度做曬好多地區工作啦，而家將個區一分為二，咁即係可能會令到成個區可能甚至嗰個地區嘅政治真係會混亂，或者係服務真空啊。咁其實對當區居民係咪公平咧？同埋會唔會影響到頭先？馮官話係冇呢個政治考慮啦，但係始終當區又係一個民主派嘅區議員，甚至係雙料議員咁。其實呢樣嘢點樣說服到市民咧？即係一個咁大嘅改動，同埋另外都有一個區域就係雷地島區咧。個長洲南、長洲北見到係將佢合併為一個選區。其實呢個合併選區係咪首次有一個咁樣嘅做法咧？唔該，馮官。
我哋係絕對冇政治考慮嘅，但係我哋做咗樣出嚟咧，我亦都唔可以話冇對本區有影響嘅。咁因為你起碼有百幾區劃咗嘅咧，咁佢梗係個人有佢自己好處唔好處。但係我哋就話某個人佢做咗幾多嘢咧，就真係唔係我哋考慮嘅。離島嗰度咧，你哋睇到喺東涌嗰度咧，加咗一席俾佢，就係長洲嗰席。都是仍然是超上限的。那我們是已經是搜索夫場，這個最大的原因呢，就是因為那個離島它很大，很普通的區在隔離呢是可以救到它的。但我們這裡它這麼多個島，還有四個其他的島呢，你看看都是下限的。但那些太遠了，又沒有交通又沒有船。那我們如果是跟回法例的字眼呢，就是沒辦法用到那些來幫的。那長洲我們考慮過呢，就是長洲一個島來講呢，它的交通沒有受限制，還有大家都是長洲而已，所以我們是做了這個是一個新的考慮。但是你說我們可以再做多一點的話呢，看回那裡呢，我們就認為做不到。如果其他有些人有些意見可以提上來，看看我們再考慮過啦。
喂，你好啊，馮官，《蘋果日報》梁永健。雖然咧，馮官你一路都強調，即係呢個考慮劃界嗰度就冇一個政治嘅考慮、政治因素喺裏邊啦。咁但係好多例子都證明，即係好似民主派嘅議員就嗰個選區被即係分割咁樣啦。但係我想問你嗰個劃界建議嗰度咧，其實成個過程有冇即係之前有冇諮詢過任何人？點解又或者點解冇咧？包括你問呢個民政事務專員話，淨係係咪淨係問嗰個命名嘅問題咧？其實佢有冇同你提供過任何其他嘅意見咧？
嗰、那個諮詢咧，我哋一定咧就係、是、自己做咗出嚟先，因為係選舉劃界。咁至於係話有啲交通嗰啲情況，我哋唔係好了解咧，我哋會問翻個地方專員嘅。因為喺個報告亦都講過咧，因為佢先至係對嗰個地區嗰個嘅。位置最認知的，但是的話呢，最緊要就是選管會是獨立的。第二呢，我們是沒有問他任何地方的行政啊那些東西的。第三呢，就是說我們後來怎樣去決定呢，都是用一條數計算出來的。這條數呢就是最客觀的了。如果有任何受影響的地區人士呢，他說他會可以有另外一個方法咧，嗰條數係最好嘅話咧，咁我哋都會係從善如流嘅。
係咪提問時間差唔多？係咪？最後一個問題啦，而家。
唔好意思，馮官，東方日報郭欣，仲想問多一條咧，就係、是、其實咧，對於呢啲劃界建議咧，之前有部分區議員都即係初步了解過啦，咁佢哋都有個批評，就係話選管會有離地啦，同埋拎住份地圖亂咁劃啦。請問對於呢啲言論有咩回應？
我頭先講咗俾你聽，法律咧就話最緊要就係個數啱，第二咧就係話嗰個社區聯繫同埋嗰啲交通啊嘅狀況。咁交通嗰啲咧係客觀嘅，我哋會去有落去睇過，亦都係睇嗰陣時咧，可能我哋覺得有需要咧，都問過嗰啲專員，但我哋係絕對冇問任何區議員嘅。咁因為佢用咗唔同嘅尺去度嘅咧，咁我諗大家唔同見解咧係可以理解嘅。咁因為嗰個法例叫我哋就話你總之條數 十字戒豆腐咁戒咗佢出嚟，就係咁樣。咁所以我哋嘅出發點唔同咧。咁你話我哋離地咧，咁我哋就話我哋係一定係宏觀，我哋唔會狹隘淨係睇自己嗰範嘅。我哋係咁多睇位，因為你有嗰、那個即係嗰個 knock on effect， 即係你會影響到第二個噶嘛。咁我哋咪就係話睇下影響最少嗰、那個，我哋咪用嗰個咯。咁如果佢係有一個，因為佢認為影響少嘅話，我哋要計翻條數，加翻啲屋，有時係就係邊度方便就去邊度攞一兩座嗰度。呢、這個即係不嬲都係咁樣做嘅。係
咁提問時間呢度係啦，結束咁麻煩法官係。
係，咁我頭先仲有兩條問題咧，就容後答你哋嘅啦。咁第一條咧就係、是、嗰個確認書咧，咁講過好多次咧，就是、因為嗰、那個有各條唔同嘅選舉法例，包括行政長官、立法會、區議會同埋村代表選舉咧，佢都要嗰個參選人咧喺嗰個提名表格做兩個聲明。就即時係要擁護基本法同埋保證效忠特別行政區，所以咧就有依個確認書咧，就其實提醒翻佢哋嘅。咁至於佢哋係嗰個參選資格係咩情況咧？咁呢個係選舉主任嘅責任，我哋選管會係完全冇參與，亦都唔知道，我哋就係睇到佢個理由，我哋先知嘅。咁所以咧，就係、是、話，因為如果係需要話俾啊啲參選人士聽，佢其實係有咁嘅宣誓要做。而根據選舉法例咧，如果佢個宣誓咧唔係真誠嘅咧，佢可能要負上刑事責任嘅話咧，所以選管會係見到社會上有啲咁嘅情況咧，所以我哋係做一個叫做解釋翻俾佢哋聽，等佢哋清楚明白。第二個咧，我哋係想講下嗰個傳媒係需要公平平等對待咁去處理個候選人嘅。咁我早前都留意過傳媒上面咧有啲報告，咁咧就係話好難運作到。首先咧就係、是、選舉活動指引咧係要求傳媒咁。是公平平等對待所有候選人，不要優待或者虧待。這個呢，我們其實這個公平的要求呢，是針對所有呢是操縱公共資源的機構，包括傳媒啦、報章啦，還有這個業主委員會啊，其他那些可以除了私人之外借地方出來那些呢，都是用的。咁呢個選舉指引咧，佢用嗰個候選人咧，佢係一直以來咧，佢係用緊選舉舞弊及非法條例行為條例裏邊嗰個候選人嘅意義嘅，即係佢係除咗係接受咗提名嘅候選人之外咧，呢、這個定義咧係擴闊咗去包括咧就係、是。在某項選舉提名期結束之前咧，任何時間曾經公開宣布有意參選的人，都是成為嘅候選人。咁呢個定義咧，係點解係咁闊咧？係因為佢原本咧係定咗嚟咧，就係、是、規管呢個選舉廣告同埋選舉開支嘅。咁因為嗰個係佢個原本目的。不過呢個選舉指引。用於傳媒章節同埋用於其他，譬如立案法團嘅咧，都係一路用翻同一個定義嘅。咁以前咧就冇聽到咁多聲音，就話運作起上嚟好困難。但係我諗而家可能係公開有意參選嘅人咧係越嚟越多，而公開宣佈嘅實際形式咧係各有不同。咁傳媒一報導嗰陣時咧，佢難免係有顧慮咧，就係、是、話哈。我是不是能夠符合這個指引的要求呢？那我說回呢，現在的選舉活動指引呢是用了這個法例上的定義，那也都不是一定要用這個定義，不過是一路是以前一路用下來，我想就是二十多年都是用了這個的。 咁我哋反而係更加想係點樣係可以公平平等去做呢件事呢？咁如果有其他嘅定義嘅話咧，又會唔會有唔公平呢？咁而家咧，我可以同各位講咧，就係話每一次大選之前嘅大約六個月度咧，選管會咧都可係會檢討翻有關嘅選舉活動指引咧，係改善啲安排嘅。嗱，剛剛有一個鄉郊選舉代表活動指引咧，咁啊公眾諮詢期咧佢就過咗噶。咁喺嗰個諮詢期嗰陣時咧，我哋又冇收到啲嘅意見，但係亦都可以理解嘅，因為嗰度嗰啲報導我諗係同其他嘅選舉咧係有差異嘅。但係明年中咧，區議會一般選舉嘅指引咧就會進行公眾諮詢嘅啦。咁咧就我希望各位咧係可以俾下意見嘅。咁但我哋當然自己都會睇嘅。咁我哋首先講咗我哋嘅原則咧，就係、是。公開公平的大原則之後呢，我們現在也都聽到聲音呢，要顧及傳媒的實際運作，我們會在兩者之間呢取得平衡，或者我們會聽回大家的意見的。 I wish to say a few words on media reporting. We've heard that, that the media, or for all intents and purposes, are the organization in control of public resources such asthe incorporated owners. They have to have fair and equal treatment for all candidates. And as to the definition of candidates, we have all along, I think since time immemorial, the EAC has used the definition in the ECICO. The ECICO definition for candidates is very wide. Apart from people who has accepted nomination,it's also included that anyone who has publicly declared the intention to run in the election before the close of nomination. I have no qualms in saying that this is a very wide definition. And it is so because it was designed for the purpose of regulating election advertisements and electoral expenses. And in the past, the using of the same definitiondid not seem to create any real problems, because it seems the problem will arise nowadays because there are more and more people publicly declaring that they are running in the election, and the means they do so is so diverse. And the media is worried that, you know, they may miss a few names and causing some concerns.May I say here that the regulations of media reporting need not use the same definition as the ECICO, so long as we have fair treatment in all the circumstances. Before each general or ordinary elections, about 6 months beforehand, we will review theelectoral activities guidelines, and it may be opportunities that when we look at the district council election activities guidelines, that this is a topic that we'll look into, and I welcome views to be put forward at that juncture. The election guidelines for the rural elections has just concluded its consultation period, and we didn't receive anythingprobably because, you know, there was not so much concern of the media in that election. But anyway, we'll look at it, and we will in the appropriate way seek the appropriate views on that, so long as we can have an open and fair principle for treating of candidates, as well as to take into account the practical operation of the media. Thank you very much.
唔該曬各位。
我哋而家未籌劃嗰個2019年嗰個選舉，但係喺上次立法會換屆選舉之後嘅每一個選舉咧，都有用確認書嘅。
唔該曬各位，係唔該曬。
意見，咁我哋就適當咁樣去睇下大家意見係點。但最緊要係可唔可以做到一個公平？